Hello, pandemic restriction fans. I'm Kevin Ripa, and this is my Sans 3 Minutes Max. Today, we're going to be talking about hashing, a very integral part of the entire encryption process. What is a hash? Well, a hash is a one-way transformation. It's a mathematical algorithm that is fed data. When the data is provided to the algorithm runs its thing on the data. So in the simplest of terms, let's say we were using ROT13 as our hashing algorithm. I mean, you never would, but so instead of ABC, ABC now becomes DEF. And so in that way, if we're using that as our algorithm, then the word cab, C-A-B, would become F-D-E. So you see how the hashing works. But obviously, it's a lot more complicated than that. It's a one-way transformation. In other words, you can't undo it once it's done. You can't take the hash and find out what the data was that created the hash. Doesn't work that way. Now, don't start yelling rainbow tables at the screen. That's not the same thing. You're not undoing a hash without other intervention. Now, it is a variable input, so whatever you put in, you get a fixed length back out. So if I put in Kevin Ripa and it's MD5 hash, I'm going to get a hash value that's 128 bits long. If I hash the entire War and Peace, it's still only going to be 128 bits long in its hash length. Again, it can't be reversed, and we use this for message integrity. Now, in the next episode, I'm going to show you a demonstration of this hashing and how it gets changed if we change the input. But essentially, what you need to know right now is you see that no matter what you put in, you're going to get a fixed length output. In this case, again, MD5 hash. This is 128 bits. To better illustrate what this might look like and the fact that we can't reverse it, well, it kind of looks like this. We can take fruit and we can put it into a blender. Once we blend it, we get fruit juice. Yeah, we can't take that fruit juice by itself and say, this is the fruit that went in and these were the amounts of the fruit. It is not reversible. So that's why we can use it as integrity. Now, how unique is it? You stand a better chance, an exponentially better chance of matching DNA from two unrelated human beings before you're going to match hash values of two dissimilar pieces of data. Again, in the next episode, we're going to show you a little more deeply what that looks like when we start changing data. But in the meantime, and in between time, that's it. Another episode of 3 Minutes Max.